Welcome to this video, demonstrating the new electronically generated Trainee Diversity Report, NERA Commons. Submitting a Trainee Diversity Report, with the Research Performance Progress Report, RPPR, is required by NIH for most training grants, institutional career development awards, and research education awards. For awardees, this has involved manually collecting the demographic information from trainees and completing the Trainee Diversity Report PDF. To make this easier and less time-consuming for awardees, ERA has developed an automated electronic process that leverages existing demographic information entered by trainees in the personal profile of ERA Commons. This minimizes the need for manual data entry by awardees. Because data is being pulled from the personal profile of each trainee, it is very important that trainees 1. Fill in their personal profile as completely as possible, paying close attention to the demographic portion of the profile. And 2. Understand that while demographic information is collected at an individual level, it is reported as aggregate data and is not associated to them as an individual. Starting October 30, 2020, the automated report is required for activity codes, shown here. For these awards, that generally require appointments through xTrain, the system will check whether the RPPRs include an electronically generated trainee diversity report. RPPRs that do not have the electronically generated report will not be accepted. You should note that for some activity codes, the use of xTrain is optional. So, for K12 KL2, R25, KM1, and R90 activity codes, the ERA system will check if the appointment has been made in xTrain. If an appointment was made using xTrain, NIH will require an electronically generated report. If no appointment was made, the system will not be able to generate a report, and a manual upload of the diversity report will be required. There are two methods that can be used to electronically generate the trainee diversity report. It can be generated from the RPPR interface, or it can be generated from the xTrain trainee roster screen. Let's look at the RPPR option first. You will navigate to the RPPR tab in ERA Commons and find the award in question. Clicking on the award number link will open the RPPR menu screen. You will open the RPPR by clicking the Edit button. This opens the RPPR screen with its various sections. Click on Section B. A new link, Generate the Trainee Diversity Report, can be found in Section B4. What opportunities for training and professional development has the project provided? To generate the report, click the link. The Trainee Diversity Report will open, completing the information on trainees by importing the demographic data provided on their personal profile. If the report looks correct, it can be attached to the RPPR by clicking the Submit for RPPR button, found in the bottom right corner of the screen, with the note stating that by clicking the button, the report will be added to the RPPR for Section B.4. A confirmation screen will be presented. If you wish to add the Trainee Diversity Report to the RPPR, click Submit. If you are completing an RPPR for one of the other activity codes, where xTrain can be used, but is not required, as a reminder, those would be K12 KL2, R25, KM1, and R90. And you in fact did not use xTrain, you will see the traditional B4 section. Here you will upload the traditional Trainee Diversity Report PDF, along with the descriptions of the training and professional development opportunities supported by the project. Now, let's access the Trainee Diversity Report through xTrain. On the Commons navigation bar, click the xTrain tab. Here, eligible awards will be listed. Under the Action column, click the Trainee Roster link. With the Trainee Roster screen now displayed, it will list the trainees for each year of the award. The Generate Trainee Diversity Report link can be found in the center of the table, in the header row for the given year. With the exception of supplement applications, those identified by the S at the end of the grant number. Because the supplement is reported with the parent, The parent RPPR will have the Trainee Diversity Report. Clicking the link generates the Trainee Diversity Report, in the exact same manner as with the RPPR method. It should be noted that the Trainee Diversity Report can be submitted to the RPPR as many times as necessary, to provide the most accurate information possible. Any previous submissions will be overwritten. This can be done up to the time that the RPPR is submitted by the signing official, to the awarding agency. You may be wondering who can generate this report. ERA users with the following roles, and, or, delegations, can generate the Trainee Diversity Report. A user with the signing official, SO, role. A user with the administrative official, AO, role. The principal investigators, PI, and multi-PI, of the grant. A user with the assistant, ASST, role, and given either the status, or RPPR delegation. A number of resources are available to you, to assist you with xTrain, should you need it. This concludes this demonstration video, of the new electronically generated Trainee Diversity Report, in ERA Commons. Thank you for watching.